with Chris Gale this afternoon from Latin Resources. Chris, good afternoon.
Hi Andrew, how are you?
Very well, Chris. Good to be speaking. Big bit of news from you in the last couple of days here. This $37 million capital raise done at the institutional level. Tell us a bit more about it.
Yeah, thanks Andrew. Look, gee, it would have been end of February we did an on-deal roadshow through São Paulo in Brazil, which is really interesting. We had five big funds there we spoke to. Went through to New York for a couple of days. Then we did PDAC, we did a conference PDAC. Then, look, a lot of people asking why we raised money when we didn't really need it. And look, the directors looked at it and we had such a lot of interest from, quality funds like PTG out of Brazil's largest investment bank. We reviewed it, had a look at it. And we thought, why don't we just go out and bulletproof ourselves? We're going to have a resource upgrade out in June. Everyone's got expecting a raise. We're not doing it now. We've got 12 months runway. We're really well funded, $57 million in the bank on Wednesday. So look, I think it was a great call at the end of the day.
Well, that's what I was going to ask. You say it was well supported by a number of new funds. So what does this mean here for Latin Resources moving forward?
Well, as our assets in South America, 70% of that 37 million came out of North America and Brazil. As we said earlier, BTG, JPG, they really rate this asset. They've been big shareholders in Sigma, who's our neighboring here, $4 billion, $5 billion market cap now. They're going to production next month. So, we've had a couple of great research reports put out by a few groups calling us the Sigma 2.0, which is fantastic for us. It's a great comparison to have. I think these funds out of Brazil have seen we could be the next Sigma 2.0. They flew the site. Tony ran through the site. I'm so impressed. The demand we got was amazing from those guys. So big tick in the box for Latin.
And I see, Chris, since the capital raise was done, your share price has held up fairly well. So you must be encouraged.
Yeah, like check generally, don't you? You sort of float back to that raise price that we did at 10.5, only 4% discount to market price. It was an amazing amount of demand. Like we could have raised a lot more, but we drew the line at 37. And it's at 12 today. So it's really held up, really well.
Well, Chris, you've recently signed this MOU here to fast track the project. Tell us a bit more about what's been agreed.
Yeah, and I think that was another key decision point for us around this raise. 3 weeks ago, we had the Ministério Investment or the agency, mining agency here in Perth. We signed an MOU. They have issued a certificate of fast track development priority project in Ministério. As people know, Ministério is one of the, it's probably the number one mining jurisdiction in Brazil, and certainly one of the best mining jurisdictions in the world. So what they've given us is a fast track development priority type certificate, which means, what does that mean? It means that once we finish our environmental studies, put that in along with our development approval application. Traditionally in Brazil, it's 12 months for the authorities to go through that. It's now down to 6 months. So as part of this fast track process, the government have lined us up with. So we wanted to raise more money to make sure that all of our studies were done on a fast track process. Now you're going to have to pay a little bit more for that, but we think it's well worth it.
What about the local community here at Salinas?
Oh, look, the reaction, the support we've got from the mining town of Salinas, every one of those, down from the mayor all the way through to the locals. We employ 60 locals on site now. We're creating jobs. They want this project to happen. And that in South America, having been operating in South America now for 15 years, it's very, very important to get the community on side very quickly. They're well and truly on side and been fantastic with their support for the Salinas project.
Well, Chris, just a final word from you. Clearly, the exploration and the resource upgrade work, that's going well. You're funded for it. What can we expect in terms of upcoming news from these different aspects?
Yeah, as we've publicly stated a number of times now, the resource upgrade will be out in June. We think with the recent drilling at Colina West, has shown significant intercept at higher grade. We're going to put out a significant upgrade resource. We'll move through now. We've delayed our PEA to flow through to July, August to take in that new upgrade. Our DFS will more likely now be completed first quarter of next year. But once again, it's going to depend on the drilling. If this resource continues to grow through to Christmas, this could be a significant tier one project. So fantastic for our investors and for our shareholders and now for the funds that invested in the company.
Good to speak, Chris. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Good on you.